Let's play. What up, gamers? T.U.G here. This is episode 21 of the Ultimate Let's Play Final Fantasy VI. Last time, a lot of stuff happened. Emperor Gastal met his demise, and Kefka pretty much destroyed the whole world, and all of our party members were separated in the aftermath. And as you can see, the world looks a lot different now. Looks a lot more... what's the word I'm looking for here? Lonely. Only one house on this island. Nothing going on. It's dead, virtually. Let's go inside the house and have a look at what's going on. Looks like Celes is in bed. Is she all alone? Looks like Cid survived as well. I guess Cid's been taking care of Celes ever since the world was destroyed. She stirs. And she's awake. Well, somebody from our team survived at least. Celes, at last. Celes, at last. You're finally awake.
I feel like I've been sleeping forever.
For 1 year, actually. I thought you were out for good.
A whole year. You've watched over me the whole time?
Yes. And I'm about out of energy. We're on a tiny deserted island. After the world crumbled, I woke us to find us here with a few strangers.
The world. So it wasn't just a dream. Where are my friends? Where's Locke?
I don't know. I only know we're here. Maybe we're the only people left alive. Since that day, the world's continued to slide into ruin. Animals and plants are dying. The few others who washed up here with us passed away from boredom and despair.
My friends, they're probably all gone.
Celes, you're the closest thing to family that I have. We could just live our lives here peacefully.
I suppose so, Cid. Or should I say, Granddad? May I call you that?
Gramps, eh? I'm overwhelmed. All of a sudden, I have a granddaughter.
My long-lost granddad. Hey, are you hungry?
I haven't eaten in 3 or so days ever since I became ill.
What would you like?
Well, unless I ask for fish, I won't get anything. That's all there is here.
I'll go catch some.
And now Cid's taking a long rest. Let's go ahead and re-equip Celes. So now we're at a part of the game where we're going to try and save Cid. Now, no matter what the end result is, the game will continue. I'm definitely going to try and save Cid, although I will reveal what happens during both scenarios once this little sequence is over. In order to save Cid, we got to catch him some fish. And depending on how fast the fish are moving, the more points they're worth. And they'll heal Cid. The slower ones, not so much. And eventually, he'll die if he doesn't get enough fish. I can't bear this any longer. Alright, so I'm just going to try my best to save him. See a really quick fish here. That'll definitely help Cid. And unfortunately, this is all also... partially luck, because sometimes you won't get the fast fish, sometimes you won't get any fish. So, it's going to be just as much luck as it is skill for this scenario here. So I'm just going to try and grab the fastest one of the bunch whenever I can. And hopefully, Cid will survive. And eventually, depending on his health, his dialogue will change. So that gives you a rough idea of how good you're doing. I feel a little better. Okay, so we're making some progress here. That's a good sign. But there's no fish, so I'm going to have to go back to Cid. And his stamina is going to go down. That's unfortunate. So I really got to make this catch count. Again, I don't want to accidentally catch the slower fish. Good, got it. And this is probably going to go on for several minutes here, so this is going to get kind of monotonous, so I'll try and be as animated as I can with my commentary. Because, yeah, this is kind of a repetitive minigame. It does get kind of boring after a time. Yeah, some people will just let Cid die. But, I'm one of those guys that likes to have everybody survive. Like, I won't play a game like Fire Emblem. I'll play the game, and if someone dies, I restart the mission. So, I kind of have a little quirk in me that says everybody's got to make it to the end. And that definitely puts a different challenge on the games that I play that have that kind of mechanic. And yeah, Fire Emblem is a good game. I don't know if I'm ever going to LP because there's just so much stuff going on. But, I don't know, maybe in the future. Depends on how much longer I keep LPing or if I decide to do something else. I don't know yet. Now, unfortunately, I don't have much of a choice of fish here, so I don't know how bad this is going to hurt me here. Well, we're still holding in that range, so good so far. Again, really no fast fish here. Well, it's better to have a fish than no fish. Alright, well, so far, no harm done. Did I put an Esper on her? You know, I might as well get her equipped, so once this scenario is over, we can start getting back into the swing of things. And I think we're eventually going to start getting our party members back, and I think they're going to have different levels depending on Celes' level. I think that they use that as a base on determining the levels of the other party members you get when you pick them up again. And I'm starting to go down a bit in terms of health. Oh, this is not good. Cid's health is starting to take a turn for the worse. He's back to where it says I can't bear it any longer. That means he's going the wrong way here. And unfortunately, the only fish here is a slow one. And for such a slow fish, it's playing pretty hard to get there. I'm getting a little worried now. I'm not long for this cruel new world. Uh-oh, that's a red flag. He's on the brink of death. I need some fast fish here. Luckily, I've got one. Come on, Cid, eat up. You're not dying on my watch. You've already done so much for us. Let me do one good thing for you here. You will live. I mean, seriously, if you die, Celes will probably just kill herself. Okay, looks like our luck's starting to turn around here. That fish came right to me. Come on, Cid. Well, at least these are not uber slow fish. This at least take us a step in the right direction, I believe. Not seeing any forward progress yet. One fish, but luckily it's a fast one. Okay. Alright, we're taking a step in the right direction now. Good, good. Man, that's only a slow fish. I hope that doesn't impede all my progress. Can I respawn it? No. Tell you the truth, I'm not sure if the slow fish are actually worse than catching no fish. I really don't know right off the top of my head. And it's been a while since I've done this scenario. A few years at least. And I've gotten to very near the end of the game in the past. But like I said in the first episode, I've never beaten this game in full. I've come very close on both the Super Nintendo and the Game Boy Advance version, which, by the way, doesn't hold a candle to the SNES. Definitely, if you're going to play this game, definitely the SNES version. I haven't tried the PlayStation version, so I would like to check that out at some point, but this has always been my preferred version of the game. It's not necessarily the same compared to all SNES ports. I mean, I've always... one of my favorite games of all time is the Dragon Warrior Dragon Quest games. And I actually like the Game Boy Color port of Dragon Warrior 3 more than I do the actual NES game that it was based off of. So, sometimes they get it right, sometimes they don't. And with the GBA version of this game, no, they didn't. Celes, thanks for all you've done for me. I think we're in very good shape now. Let's get that fast fish. I think we've almost got Cid here. Come on, get over here. Don't want to accidentally grab the slower of the bunch. Come on, come on. There you go. Gotcha. Hey, Celes is a good fisherwoman there. All right. Unfortunately, we only got one fish here. Well, at least it's not the slow one. At least Cid's still walking around a bit. Okay. We're holding. There's a fast one there. Good. Good, good, good. All right. I'm feeling a little bit better now.
My dear, I feel like I'm not going to be around much longer.
What? I thought we were making progress here. Do I have to do this in so many fish or what? I do not want all this effort to be for naught. That kind of scared me, Cid. Come on. Come on, Cid, pull through. I can't tell if that was a step back or a step forward. I'm just going to keep going for the fast fish here. I'm just hoping for the best. I guess that's a good thing that he says that. I don't know. But we're getting a good string of fast fish here, so I'm not complaining.
I feel much better. Thanks, Celes.
I think we saved them. Excellent.
What's up?
Celes, the project that kept me going over the past year is down below. Go have a look at it.
All right. We did it, Cid. We saved you. Oh, a raft. We can finally leave the island.
Granddad?
Celes, you must leave this place. You have to find your friends.
I know, but I'll bring them all back to meet you.
That lock fellow too, no doubt.
Alright, scenario complete, and Celes is going to take this raft and head to the mainland. Cid is there to see us off. Now, had Cid died, basically what would have happened was Celes would have gone to the mountain on the north side of the island and basically just jumped off as if to end it all. But she would have washed up on shore and found a seagull with Locke's bandana on it, after which she would have gained new resolve and found a note from Cid in the house that said go downstairs, and then they would have found the raft. And we would eventually get to this part right here where Celes is going to sail to the mainland to resume her journey to find the remainder of the team. So I think at this point here, I'm going to go ahead and call it quits, and we'll start a whole new adventure in the next episode. So until next time, I'm T.U.G. Later, gamers.